Hi students, hope you go through the previous sessions properly. And in the last session I told you to go through how to write the molecular formula. So today our session is how to write the molecular formula. In order to write the molecular formula, two things are essential. First one is valency. Second one is symbol of elements. In order to study the symbol of elements, we want to follow certain criteria, and that we can study from the periodic table. Now look at the periodic table. As I have mentioned earlier, 118 elements are there, and they are arranged in 18 columns and 7 horizontal rows, and this arrangement is known as periodic table. And you can see the symbol of elements here. And how to write the symbol of elements, you must go through it. The first letter will be always capital letter, for example hydrogen, H only. Suppose another element begins with the letter H itself, then the second letter should be small letter. For example, helium. First letter is H, second letter is E, and that is small letter. Okay, HE. Now, another one is boron, capital letter B. Beryllium comes BE. In the same way, nitrogen capital N, sodium NA. So, while we go through the periodic table, some elements have the name with the English letters itself. Some elements got their names from their Latin word. For example, the sodium gets Na from its Latin word, that is natrium. Then potassium gets K from its word, that is calcium. Then some are based upon color, some are based upon their country. We can remember our scientist Madame Curie. Madame Curie discovered one element, polonium, while she was discovering radioactivity and all this, while she was working with the uranium ore, uranium ore, that is pitch blend. She got another radioactive element, and in order to honor her motherland Poland, she gave the name polonium for that. Okay, you can see it there, polonium, P-O, okay, polonium, atomic number 84. So, in this way, so this is an activity for you, just to go through the periodic table and identify the symbol and how it is obtained. Some are from their Latin word, some are from their color, chromium and all these are from color. Some are from the laboratories or from countries, California, all this. Some are from universities. Then some are from scientists. Einsteinium is there, Mendelevium is there. So just to go through the periodic table and identify how these names are there. Okay, so the thing you want to remember is first letter is capital letter and second letter should be small letter while writing the molecular, while writing the symbol of elements. Okay, that you want to keep it in your mind. So, come to our point. We want to write the molecular formula. Before going to molecular formula, we want to know about atoms, molecules, atomicity, valency, elements and compounds. Once again, recall all this. What is the definition of atoms? Atoms are the building blocks of matter, and they are the smallest particle that can take part in a chemical reaction. Atoms are the smallest particle that can take part in a chemical reaction. Why atoms are take part in chemical reaction? Because very few atoms of elements are able to exist in single form or as a single atom, because they want to attain stability. In order to
obtain stability. How they will get stability? If and only if they have 8 electrons in the valence shell. That is called octet rule. How they will get 8 electrons in the valence shell? Either by sharing or by giving or by accepting, they will get 8 electrons in the valence shell. And that is the reason for chemical bonding. Okay? Either by transfer of electrons or by sharing, atoms are trying to attain 8 electrons in the valence shell. Okay? And that is the reason for in order to make molecules. And molecules are stable. Atoms are, very few atoms are stable. So they are, either they will convert into molecules or they will convert into ions. What are ions? Charged atoms are known as ions. Charged atoms. Charged atoms are called ions. So how atoms become charged? Either by losing or by sharing electrons. Either by losing or by sharing electrons, the atoms are converted into ions. If they are losing electrons, they will get positive charge and they are called cations. And if they are accepting electrons, they are called anions. Okay? Either by losing or by gaining electrons, atoms become ions and they will try to become stable. And if they are losing electrons, they will get positive charge. Why? Because in the nucleus, positively charged protons are there. And equal number of electrons are revolving around the nucleus in fixed path. That is shell. You have studied the structure of atom. And the number of electrons in the valence shell is equal to the valency. Either the number of electrons in the valence shell or 8 minus the number of electrons in the valence shell is equal to the valency. That we will discuss later. By losing electrons, what happens? Number of electrons will be less than that of protons in the nucleus. So they will get, protons will be higher, so they will get positive charge. How the negatively charged particles will come? They will accept electrons. So total number of protons inside the nucleus will be less than the total number of electrons. So they will get negative charge. Understand? And while writing a molecular formula of the form AB, this A part will be cation. That is positive, and B part will be anion, that is negative charge. Okay, the A part will be cation and B part will be anion, and this A part or this part will have the same that is the same word itself, but the B part, the anion part, always ends with a suffix em or 8 or something like that. For example, NaCl, sodium chloride. C should be capital, L should be small. NaCl. What is the name? Sodium chloride. Why we are not calling this as chlorine? Chloride. Because chlorine atom accept one electron and become negatively charged ion. That is Cl minus ion. And sodium atom donate one electron and it becomes Na plus. So Na plus and Cl minus, so this electrostatic force of attraction is responsible for bonding, and this type of bonding is known as ionic bond by the transfer of electrons. Okay, so this left hand side positive particles will be there, and the right hand side the negative or anion particles will be there. Got it? Okay. So, atoms are what? They are the smallest particles and the combining up, what happens, that is atoms are the small atoms are the smallest particles, and they are the smallest particles which can take part in a chemical reaction. Okay, and why they are undergoing chemical reaction? In order to get stability. Then atoms combine together to give molecules. Atoms combine together to give molecules. So what are molecules? They are the smallest particle of a substance which have all the properties of that substance. Okay, then what are elements? Elements are the substance having only one type of atoms. Elements are or one type of atoms or one type of molecule. Both are okay. Elements, in elements only one type of atoms and that atoms combine together to give molecule. So only one type of atoms or molecules will be there. Then what are compounds? In compounds there will not be any atoms will be there. Atoms combine together to give molecules, and in compounds molecules only. Okay. So and the force of attraction with which the atoms are combined together, that is called a chemical bond. Okay, then how the ions are forming? Either by losing or by gaining electrons. Normally what is atomic number? All these are we are recalling from our fourth chapter, that is a structure of atoms. Atoms are electrically neutral, and the number of protons inside the nucleus or the number of electrons revolving around the nucleus is known as atomic number, and that is the identity card, or each element have its own atomic number. Then what is mass number? The sum total of protons and neutrons inside the nucleus. Atomic number and mass number, that we will discuss while we are discussing calculating the molecular mass. Okay, so atoms we discuss, molecules we discuss. Next term is atomicity. What is mean by atomicity? That is the total number of atoms in a molecule. The total number of atoms in a molecule is called atomicity. So how can we calculate the atomicity? Monoatomic, diatomic, triatomic, polyatomic, etc. For example, helium. Helium is a monoatomic because helium comes under the noble gas category. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, all these are in the periodic table. You can see in the extreme left, that is in the 18th column. Okay, so they are existing as X. Their valency is zero, so they are existing in as monoatomic. Okay, so only one atom will be there, so that is called a monoatomic. Now, hydrogen, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine, all these bromine, all these elements are existing as diatomic. Why they are calling diatomic? Because two atoms combine together to give a molecule. So in a molecule, two atoms are there. It is called a diatomic. Okay, diatomic. Now consider ozone. Ozone, O3. Always the number of atoms we will represent it as the suffix. Okay, we will represent as suffix, and number of molecules we will write as prefix, in the left hand side. Okay, ozone, three oxygen atoms combined together, so it is triatomic. Now, monoatomic, we discuss only one atom will be there. Diatomic, two atoms will be there. Then, triatomic, three atoms will be there. Then, more than three, that is called polyatomic. polyatomic, more than three. For example, phosphorus, P4. Four phosphorus atom combined together to give phosphorus molecule. Then, sulfur. Eight sulfur atoms combined together, and the structure of sulfur is very interested. That is a crown-like structure. Okay, different allotropes are there for sulfur. That is alpha sulfur is there, beta sulfur is there. So many allotropes are there. Phosphorus also. Okay, red phosphorus is there, white phosphorus is there. You have studied in 8th standard. Remember, white phosphorus, red phosphorus and all this. And this is the structure of sulfur. That is a crown-like structure. So eight atoms combined together to give molecule. So what is atomicity? The number of atoms present in a molecule is called atomicity. And two types of molecules are there. What are they? That is homoatomic and heteroatomic. Homoatomic and heteroatomic. Homoatomic elements are homoatomic. What do you mean by homoatomic? Only one type of atoms are present in it. Okay? Then what is heteroatomic? You have studied in your second chapter, that is homo and hetero. Hetero means different. So in compounds, different types of atoms are there. So in H2SO4, sulfuric acid, what will be the atomicity? 2 hydrogen atom plus 1 sulfur atom plus 4 oxygen atom. So atomicity will be 4 plus 1 plus 2 is equal to 7. Okay. Then H2O, what will be the atomicity? 2 plus 1, 3. Carbon dioxide, what will be the atomicity? 1 plus 2, 3. So the total number of atoms in a molecule is known as atomicity. Okay. Then what is valency? The combining capacity of an atom is known as valency. The combining capacity of an atom. That means how many electrons are required for that atom to complete its octet. Okay? So easy to remember. I will tell you one shortcut. If the number of electrons in the valence shell is 1 to 4. Number of E dash S is the short form for electrons. Number of electrons is 1 to 4. Valency will be that number itself. Okay, that number itself. That is for hydrogen atom. What is that valency? Valence shell, only one electron is there. Valency 1. Then lithium atom, what is the molecular what is the electronic configuration? K2L1, one electron in the valence shell. So valency 1 itself. Beryllium, what is the valency? K2L2, so valency 2. Boron, K2L3, so what is the valency? 3. Carbon, K2L4. So what is the valency? 4. So in the same way, if the number of electrons in the valence shell is 1 to 4, the valency will be that number itself. Okay? Then, if number of electrons is 4 to 8, then balance E will be, there is a shortcut to calculate, that is 8 minus the number of electrons in the valence shell. 8 minus the number of electrons in the valence shell. For example, oxygen atom. Oxygen atom, what is atomic number? 8. So, KN. I hope you have studied all this. That is why I am writing this. If you are not able to, understand how to write the electronic configuration, one second, I will get one session. Okay, I am telling like this just because you have completed structure of atom. That is why. So, atomic number 8. So, 2. Then what is remaining? 6. So, how many electrons are there in the valence shell of oxygen atom? 6. So, what will be the valency of oxygen? 8 minus 6 is equal to 2. 8 minus 6 is equal to 2. So, while in the same way, fluorine atom. Fluorine. What is the atomic number? 9. Atomic number will always written as the suffix just in the left hand side. And mass number will be written at the top. That I will tell you later. Okay. So, 9. What will be the electronic configuration? K2L7. So, 8 minus 7 is equal to 1. Okay? Then case of argon. Atomic number 80. What is the electronic configuration? K2L8M8. 8 plus 8, 16 plus 2, 18. So, how many electrons are there in the valence shell? 8 electrons. So, what will be the valency? 8 minus 8, 0. Okay. In the same way, neon. Atomic number 10. 2, 8. So, what happens? Valence shell, 8 electrons. 8 minus 8, 0. What about helium? Helium. Atomic number 2. K, 2. But K shell can accommodate only 2 electrons. So, that also have valency 0. Okay, never subtract 8 minus 2. That is why, or its valency is 2 valence shell electron. Because it is the first shell can accommodate only 2 electrons. And that is completed. That is why the valency of helium is 0. Understand? So, all elements in the noble gas or 18th group in the extreme right of the periodic table have valency 0. Just below that is 17th group, that is called halogens, that is what fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Okay, and astaxanthin is there, that is a radioactive element. So all these have the 7 electrons in the valence shell and their valency is number of electrons in the valence shell is 7 and valency is 1 itself. Okay? Valency 1 itself. So, always remember that the extreme left valency will be the number of electrons in the valence shell itself. In the extreme right, we are not considering noble gases, that is the last group. And their valency will be, that is carbon onwards, carbon family onwards, what will be valency will be 8 minus the number of electrons in the valence shell. And always remember, in normal cases, valency will be vary from 1 to 4 and 4 to 1. But there are certain other cases also. For example, phosphorus, I told you, it have two valencies, 3 and 5 are there. How the phosphorus get 3 and 5, that I will explain now. Phosphorus. What is the atomic number of phosphorus? 15. So, what is the electronic configuration? K2L8M5. So, number of electrons in the valence shell? 5. 8 minus 5 is equal to 3. That is why phosphorus In our note, I will give you two valences, 5 and 3. Okay? So, that's all about valency. Next, we are going to study how to write the molecular formula. What are the things essential to write molecular formula? First one, we have a thorough idea about the valency and symbol of elements. Then only we are able to write the molecular formula. Then what is the other thing we want to remember? The positively charged or cation part will be right first and the anion part will be right in the later only. Okay, left hand side will be cation part, that is positively charged, and anion part will be negatively charged. And anionic portion will be ends with the suffix -ium or -ate or some suffix will be there. Okay, that we will, while we are going through it, that I will tell you. Oxide, bromide, iodide, sulfide. Okay, then sulfate is there. That is another one, that is polyatomic ion. Okay, so two things essential. One is symbol, second one is valency. Next, we are going to write a general formula. If two atoms A and B, atoms A and B are atoms of different elements. Okay, atoms of different elements having valency X and Y. Okay, two atoms of different elements A and B having valency X and Y combined together. This is the general form. Always keep it in your mind. Two atoms A and B combines together, then their valency will be in such a way that just write the valencies in the opposite way, that is AYBX. Okay, always keep it in your mind. And if the valency is 1, no need to write this suffix. If the valency is 1, no need to write the suffix. While we are practicing, it will be clear to you. So, this is the general form. If two elements A and B having valencies X and Y respectively, then the molecule formed by these two elements have the molecular formula AYBX. They are interchanging the valencies. Interchanging the valencies. If I am telling like this, you will be a little bit confusion. How can we write this? So, we can do it with certain examples. Okay. First one is sodium chloride. Sodium chloride. Why we are writing chloride, not chlorine? Because chlorine in here, chlorine atom accept one electron and becomes a anion, negatively charged one. Okay, sodium chloride. So, what is the symbol of sodium? Na. Why N capital and A small? I told you, second letter, if there is a second letter in the symbol, that should be written in small letter. Okay, chlorine. C-L. Okay, then next we are writing the valencies at the top. What is the valency of sodium? 1. What is the valency of chlorine? 1. Now, interchanging the valencies. While we are writing the molecular formula, there will not be any space between the symbol of elements. Na, Cl, Na1, Cl1, interchanging. Both are 1, no need to write. So, the molecular formula of sodium chloride is NaCl. Another example, magnesium chloride. Magnesium The only thing I changed is the cation portion I changed. Anion portion is as such.
So magnesium, what is the symbol? Mg. As usual, M capital, G small. Chloride, Cl. What is the valency of magnesium? 2. What is the valency of chlorine? 1. Interchanging the valencies or cross. Mg, Mg1, 1 is written here, Cl2. Since C1 is there, no need to mention. So the molecular formula of magnesium chloride is MgCl2. Okay.
Next we can study the molecular formula of hydrogen sulfide. See, always keep it in your mind. Sulfide is S minus. Later we will study about sulfate, barium sulfate, sulfuric acid, so far I told you. So that is another radical that is called polyatomic ion, SO4 2 minus. Don't misunderstand between sulfide and sulfate. This is sulfide. Okay. Hydrogen symbol H. Sulfur symbol S. What is the valency of hydrogen? 1. What is the valency of sulfur? 2. Interchanging the valencies, we will get H2S. If the valency is 1, no need to mention. So that's all about the how to write the molecular formula. By practice, you are able to write it. I will give you some worksheet. Practice it. Okay. The two things essential, what are they? First one is you must thorough about the symbol of elements. Second one, you must thorough about the valency of elements. Third one, always remember that the positive part should be written first, then only the negative part. Or cationic part first, then only anionic part. Okay, next we are going to write, while writing, ions I told you, what are ions? Charged atoms. Then charged atom groups are the and they are called polyatomic ions. Charged atom groups are there and they are called polyatomic ions. For example, SO4 2 minus, NO3 minus, PO4 3 minus, then CO3 2 minus. All these I will give one table so it is easy for you to study this. And for them, so for one atom, we can say the number of electrons in the valence shell is considered as its valency, or 8 minus the number of electrons in the valence shell is considered as valency. But in case of polyatomic ions, they are charged. Have you seen at the top certain numbers are given? 2 minus, 3 minus, minus, 2 minus, or ammonium, NH4 plus. Okay, so this number is considered as its valency. Okay. What is the valency of carbonate? This ion is called a carbonate. This one is called a phosphate. This one is called a nitrate. This one is called a sulfate. Okay. This one is called a ammonium. Ammonium. All these are ends with A and this ends with EM. Why? All these are negatively charged and this one is positive charged. So, positively charged or cationic polyatomic ions are ends with the suffix ion. And negatively charged will either ends with the H or ends with the ite, sulfite, phosphite, or these are the. Okay. So, while we are writing molecular formula with the polyatomic ions, while writing polyatomic ions, for example, I will write here ammonia. ammonium chloride. Ammonium chloride. NH4, this is the symbol for ammonium, NH4 plus chloride, Cl minus. Both have only one charge, so their formula is NH4Cl. Now another one, ammonium sulfate. Ammonium sulfate. Chloride instead of chloride, I am writing another polyatomic ion, sulfate. What is the formula? SO4 2 minus. So interchanging the valencies, what happens? NH4, SO4. So if we are writing 2 here, it is difficult. So in case of polyatomic ions, if the number, while we are interchanging the valences, if the number exceeds 1, then that should be written in a bracket. NH4 twice. At that time not 2, it will be called twice, thrice, in that way. NH4 twice, SO4. Okay? Now, another example. Aluminium sulfate. Don't misunderstand between aluminium and ammonium. Okay. Aluminium. What is the symbol? Al. What is the valency? 3. So interchanging. What will be? Al. SO4. Aluminium. 2. Sulfate in bracket. 3. Al2. SO4. Thrice. In this way, we are able to write the molecular formula of polyatomic ions. So, in order to write the molecular formula, you must thorough about the symbol, as I have mentioned earlier, symbol of elements, then their valency, then the names of polyatomic ions and their valencies. Okay? So, you are able to write this. Understand? So, that's all about this session. Do the molecular formula of compounds again and again and again. So by practice only you will be familiar how to write the molecular formula. Practice it. Okay. And just to go through the periodic table understand the symbols and their names. Okay. Even if you are not studying periodic table, but it is essential for you to study how to write the molecular formula and to calculate molecular mass. Okay. Next session will be how to calculate molecular mass and mole concept. Okay. Next session we will discuss about mole concept, and today's session we discuss about how to write the molecular formula. In order to write the molecular formula, what are the things essential? First one is symbol of elements. Second one is their valences. And we have an idea about atoms, molecules, ions, then atomicity, valency and all this. Okay. Then what is atomicity? The number of atoms in a molecule. Then what is mean by monoatomic molecule? If in a molecule or in an element only one atom is there. If an element have only one atom in their molecule, that is, they are known as monoatomic. Helium, neon, argon, gold, platinum, silver, all these are examples for monoatomic molecules. Then, diatomic molecules, if in a molecule two atoms are there, they are called diatomic molecules. If three atoms are there, they are called polyatomic molecule. Triatomic molecule. Three and more are normally called polyatomic, but three atoms are in a molecule, it is called triatomic. Okay, 4 and above are called polyatomic. So always remember, phosphorus and sulfur are example for polyatomic molecules. Okay, that is in case of elements. In molecules, so many are there, and compounds, they are atoms of different elements are combined together. So they are called heteroatomic molecules. And homo elements have homoatomic molecules, or we can say only one type of atoms combined together to give molecules. Okay. Then what are ions? Either by losing or gaining atoms are attempt to obtain stability. And positively charged atoms are called cations, and negatively charged atoms are called anions. Or simply we can say charged atoms are called ions, and charged atom groups are called polyatomic ions or radicals. Their name and their charge and symbols, everything should be by heart. At least 8 or 9 are most common polyatomic ions are there, that I will give as a chart. Either in parent day or in note I will give you. So study it properly, then practice. Worksheet will be there. I will provide some worksheet. You must do it, and please WhatsApp or in the parent day, please show me that photos of your worksheet. Okay, I will upload the worksheet in the next day only. So study all this. These are the things we want to study regarding molecular formula. Thank you.